Good afternoon. This is the F-21, for India, from India. This airplane is going to be uniquely designed to meet the IAF requirements. First, I'd like to start at the nose of the airplane. In this airplane, we are putting our third generation AESA radar. The first generation radar was designed and developed in our Block 60. From there, it went to the F-35, and now we're bringing it back in to the F-21. Inside the cockpit, there's going to be a large area display. Similar technology that we have on the F-35. So with Lockheed Martin, we have a family of fighters. We're able to mix and match the technologies from one platform to another. If you look on the wingtip, we are adding a triple missile launcher adapter. What that does, it allows you to carry 40% more air-to-air missiles than any configuration. If you look at the CFT on the side, it's a conformal fuel tank. That provides extended range. We have a probe for refueling. So the F-21 has both probe and drogue refueling and boom refueling. The only aircraft in the world that offers both types of refueling. The airplane is powered by a GE-129 engine. Allows us to go further and faster than other airplanes in the competition. You peel back the skin from the airplane and look in the airplane. The structure has been updated to a 12,000-hour service life. That is 50% more flying time on any other platform that's in the competition. So what does that mean? Typically, you fly 150 to 180 hours. When you have the 12,000-hour service life, this airframe will be able to fly for 80-plus years without any kind of structural upgrade. The last thing I'd like to point out is the EW system. EW is going to be designed uniquely or the Indian Air Force to be able to counter threats that they uniquely face. So with that, if you simply look at the F-21, it can fly further, go faster, stay longer, and carry more ordnance than any other platform that's in the competition. So simply put, the F-21 is integrates into the existing fleet of the Indian Air Force.